In another video, I showed you my 24 centimeter amateur television transmitter, and in this case I show you my 13 centimeter ATV transmitter. It's never completed in a cupboard, but it is used often. It has no audio, it's also not finished. This has about 400 milliwatt output, and it also has a free running oscillator, so that's possible. On the back, only two trimmers to adjust for the maximum output, and the rest is all straightforward.
I'll show some more details about this circuit, and to start with the voltage. This is the voltage line, plus 12 volt, 13 volt, and it goes to a potentiometer, and that potentiometer you can adjust the frequency with, because this is the oscillator part and this is the modulator part, and the modulator contains a pre-emphasis. Maybe another video to explain what pre-emphasis is, but this part is pre-emphasis, and also the DC to a varicap diode. And this is the oscillator, a single transistor, and the varicap will be somewhere behind, below this trimmer, and you can adjust with this trimmer the roughly the frequency, and with this potentiometer you adjust the DC voltage on the varicap, and therefore you adjust the frequency, and it is also modulated on the varicap. The output of this transistor is going to this monolithic amplifier, MAR8 or so, I'm not quite sure, I don't remember. And when this all functions on the correct frequency, you can add another compartment. You can see that I did it like that. And then you see a strange circuit. It is all BFG transistors, four times. With no adjustable items on this amplifier. This is the strip line, this is the strip line, so it's just the lag of the capacitor forms the frequency dependent part. And this brings the level up, the power level up, and then we come to the final stage. It is a BFG34T, and with this trimmer and this trimmer, and here's another trimmer behind, you can adjust the output to 400 milliwatts. Straightforward design, and the frequency is of course adjustable, and it is somewhere in the 13 centimeter amateur television band.
As just explained, the oscillator is free running, and it is possible to use it over a local repeater or so, but it would be very nice if you have a frequency readout and you know exactly where you are in the band, and you can easily adjust the frequency. If you subscribe, then you will find the next time a video about that transmitter. See you!